Hello, my jelly fighters. My name is Jim, and this is your Daily Brogue for the 18th of October, 2021. I do not know sometimes, I do not understand sometimes how people can be so completely unaware of what's going on. So, you know, what they're doing, how they're treating other people. This goes especially for the left. And I think this in particular, I mean, obviously there's the whole deplorables comment, right? And Obama's similar comment several years earlier about, I won't get it right, but, you know, all those stupid rednecks clutching their guns out of fear in their podunk towns that don't even deserve a mention. So those ideas, those get transmitted and so forth and so on. The most important thing to me here, look at that. There's one key. There should be another key around here somewhere. Two rat traps. Let's see what we can do with this. Okay, this might be all right. I don't know where the... There we go. Three. Oh, very nice. I'm gonna try a couple more of these each. Levitation. Very good now. Awareness, probably. Okay, so I don't know how I ended up. I ended up here, right? I was, you know, I did the crap this morning. See, there we go. This would be better if I had something to... Okay, so let's see. One thing I can do, I think, is sort of pre-release some of these guys. That's no good. By doing that, I make it less dangerous. Okay. So I have no idea where I got this. I mean, this is one of these things where I was sitting around and that's good. It's a one of empowerment. Don't need Seth linking too crappy. So what happens is, of course, I find somehow, and I don't know how, a bunch of journalists complaining that the alt-right is being mean to them, of course, by telling them to learn to code, and how learn to code is hate speech. And as much as I might want to feel for them, right? I mean, in this case, what was going on was there were massive layoffs in 2019. That did that in. And thanks to those massive layoffs, you know, people were upset and people were mean to the kids that got laid off, and it's sad. It's sad they got laid off, these journalists. But, you know, sometimes it's not like they couldn't have seen that coming, right? Bad things have been going on in the newspaper industry for a long time. There's no real reason to suspect that they'd get any better. So the question then becomes, should they expect that to be treated well by everybody on the internet after that? Should they be upset when some people on the right aren't super happy about, aren't, you know, super supportive, let's say. They're just not very supportive of these journalists who've lost their jobs. And maybe not. I mean, think about what's been going on. Like I said, the high-profile things came with the politicians, but journalists have been very, very anti-white trash, let's say, for a long time. They've been very, very anti poor whites. For whatever reason, right? I mean, we don't have to get into that because I don't know what the reason is, right? But good. But, you know, that contempt is palatable, palpable, the journalists found it palatable, they enjoyed it very much, gave them someone to hate, they had to stop hating the black people, so they need to find someone better to hate, because it was no longer fashionable, of course. So the journalists treat this set of people with disdain. And then they're upset when these same people don't seem to be particularly supportive. No way, that's okay. On the other hand, as soon as these people, as soon as people start being mean to them, saying, You know, basically get a job saying, learn to code after they've lost their job, which is quite rude. This is not, you know, nice, but it is hardly a call for lynching, despite the fact that this article from Think Progress, The Weaponization of Learn to Code by Jessica M. Goldstein, makes it sound like even this mild criticism is severe anti-Semitism. And literally in here she says, by saying learn to code, what you're really saying is gas the Jews, right? So, I mean, literally that's what she's saying. She's saying that's what it means. And she uses sort of a Southern Poverty Law Center guilt by association way to do that. I mean, it really just feels like these guys have never spent any time thinking that, the way that they treat people could ever come back to them, right? That somebody might not like it when you call them names, basically. I mean, that's basically what newspaper reporters do, what editorialists do, is they call a bunch of other people names and then pretend they're upset. Crap. I didn't even notice that. Now I'm screwed. Busy watching the guys die. And this is because they feel like any uneducated person, they have some sort of But I've never really understood how they could not know what complete assholes they are. Let's see. Obviously, this had something to do with Trump, but in the article, decided to repeat some of the canards, right? Misrepresentation of Trayvon Martin, right, and George Zimmerman. So this is doubly weird, since, of course, George Zimmerman is Afro-Peruvian, so being African and Hispanic probably should at least entitle you to being more the worst thing that could have happened. Oppressed than Martin. This is the confused one. Is he still confused? No. So they went, I mean, they have good examples of bad things that happened. Trayvon Martin wasn't sitting around eating Skittles, right, when he assaulted George Zimmerman. All right, so if you can't acknowledge that, you can't talk about the problems. Can't talk about these problems. Right, I mean, I'm particularly callous, right? I say, if you hit somebody, if you punch a man with a gun, let's say, you sort of deserve what you got. You know, not in some sort of existential way, but in a survival of the fittest sort of way, right? Some things you probably shouldn't do, and that's hit somebody, you know, attack somebody who's better armed than you. And that was pretty obvious pretty soon after the event in question. Strength. Okay, so if I can get there. similarly. That's the best. These guys. Oh, there's a thing there. Throw R, not remove. Crabby. Shit. So, like out of my finger, reaping an awareness, not a great awareness. Crap. Seventy-thirty bad good, but so basically in this same situation, guy's gonna come back. Well, felt like that jelly. Just shit. if I had a buddy, I've got a wanted impoundment. They did the same thing with the dudes at the Lincoln Memorial, right? So you had an old Indian activist who had originally been kind of snide. Or been kind of bad, actually. Oh, crap. So one of these things where we'd been given half a video, right? And it looked like this poor old man was being harassed at the Washington or the Lincoln Memorial. Turned out he had just been a dick. And we just got the end point of that dictitude. So, obviously you want to make your points, but it's sort of like, well, can't you do it with some self-awareness? Can't you don't you realize that the first draft is never a very good one, right? I mean, if the New York Times is the first draft of history, you know, that's its claim, then it's all well and good, but there have to be some revisions beyond that, right? And to be honest, the Trayvon Martin thing is one of things I look for. When assessing whether or not somebody's being honest, right? So if somebody continues to use the Trayvon Martin affair, in a particular way, then I generally don't trust them, right? Its original use really was polemic, and it wasn't, people weren't worried about what actually happened, or even who the people were, right? Or not. So, oops. Thank you. bad, and it's not over. Anyways, it just annoyed me, the thing. Even if it were unpalatable people that were saying that, you know, learn to code to these people who went to, I don't know, Columbia and got their journalism master's degrees and stuff like that. You know, if you've spent all this time, right, I mean, you know, attacking people like Jessica M. Goldstein did in this, the weaponization of learn to code, if you spend all that time demonizing all that trailer trash as Nazis, then they're not going to be nice to you, right? They're going to treat you the way you treat them. And that's pretty much what's going on here. So Goldstein here is saying that Facebook was not doing enough to censor people's views. Same thing with Twitter, same thing with YouTube, right? We're all too free here because, you know, I can punch you, but you can't punch me, that sort of deal. And people have all sorts of views about who can punch whom. But in a free society, everyone gets to be mean to everyone else. All right. Only in a fascist society does one person get to be mean to someone else, and the other person doesn't get to hit back.